Hello, you guys. Welcome back. Praise be to God. This is Lovely Waters again. I'm so happy to be here, like I always say, because I really indeed am. I've got so much to share with you today, and I just pray by God's grace that we'll get to it. The first thing I want to say is that He's coming soon. In the background, we have Kirk Franklin and the family, Behold the Lamb, to commemorate our season of His birth. But I also want you to know that that was the first time He came. That's what Christmas is about. But I want to share with you today that He's coming again, and He's coming soon. So, it's my job as a messenger to tell you to prepare, because He has given me a mandate to prepare the way of the Lord. I want to share something really quick with you, coming from Luke, the 21st chapter. And it says, there will be signs in the sun and in the moon and in the stars, and on the earth, and there will be distress of nations. Don't we see that now? Distress among nations, and perplexity, and the sea and the waves roaring. Men's hearts are failing. Men's hearts will fail them from fear and the expectations of those things which are coming to the earth. For the powers of the heavens will be shaken. We're dealing with anxiety through COVID-19. We're looking around us wondering what else is coming, because we know, the earth knows, even in the core of this earth, it knows that He's coming soon. Let us pray. Father, we thank You, O God, for this hour that, Lord God, You have given us. Father, to come, O God, and to, Lord God, to take a moment out for You. Father, we lift up our eyes to the hills from whence cometh our help. Father, we know that You are our help. We believe, O God, that Your word is right and Your word is true. Father, we pray, O God, that You will continue to fill our hearts. Continue to fill our hearts, Lord Jesus, with questions. Fill our hearts, Lord God, with, Lord Jesus, a mind to seek You. Lord, give us a hunger and a thirst for Your righteousness, that we might be filled. Father, open up our eyes that we might see. Open up our ears that we might hear. Oh God, lead and guide every step. Lord, draw us, for no one can come to You except You draw them. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. All right. Praise God. What I want to start today is, I'm starting with the word today concerning trouble. The word that I want to share today with you is for those who find themselves in trouble. For you know, at some point in all of our lives, and more often than not, we do find ourselves in trouble. And you know, some people say some people are going out of trouble while others are coming into trouble. But we have learned, those of us that have matured, we've learned that life is full of trouble. So this today, our show, I want to dedicate it to those who are in trouble. But not only that, but I want to be a troubleshooter today. Amen. I come to shoot trouble today. It's my intent to kill trouble today by way of the word of God and by His Spirit. that you, regardless of what kind of trouble that you are facing today, you guys be patient with me today because I've got a word. Regardless of what trouble that you are facing today, you may be facing oppression, lack, sickness, doubt, loneliness, confusion in your home or in your family, feeling insecure due to failure in your career or educational endeavors, hatred, discrimination, loss of a loved one, unemployment, business, your business may be failing, whatever your trouble, I am coming to you. God has sent me to be a troubleshooter today. And I want to shoot it dead. I want to kill trouble today by his word. In the name of Jesus and by the authority of the Holy Spirit. I also want to begin with the word of God. Amen. We're going to start with Psalm, if you'd like to go with me. Psalm 10 and verse 1. And it says, Why do you stand afar off, O Lord? Why do you hide in times of trouble? This is David praying. The wicked in his pride persecutes the poor. Let them be caught in the plots which they have devised. For the wicked boasts of his heart's desire. He blesses the greedy and renounces the Lord. The wicked in his proud countenance does not seek God. God is in none of his thoughts. His ways are always prospering. Isn't that funny? Your judgments are far above and out of his sight. As for all his enemies, he sneers at them. He has said in his heart, I shall not be moved. I shall never be in adversity. And his mouth is full of cursing and deceit and oppression. I'm going to skip down to verse 11. And it goes, he has said in his heart, God has forgotten. He hides his face. He will never see. These are enemies. Arise, O Lord. O God, lift up your hand. Do not forget the humble. Why do the wicked renounce God? He has said in his heart, you will not require an account. But you have seen, for you observe trouble and grief, to repay it by your hand. The helpless commits himself to you. You are the helper of the fatherless. Break the arm of the wicked and the evil man. Seek out his wickedness until you find none. The Lord is king forever and ever. The nations have perished out of his land. Lord, you have heard the desire of the humble. You will prepare their heart. You will cause your ear to hear, to do justice to the fatherless and the oppressed, that the man of the earth may oppress no more. You know, we find that happens often in our lives. I know I have in mind, where it seems like those who do evil, they seem to prosper in their wicked ways. But God came to share with us today the truth that he sees. And God may not come when we want him to. I reiterate that with all of my heart. But he came today to give you a heads up that he has an appointed time. Amen. That he will arise and cause our enemies to be scattered. So let's move right along here. Our next scripture is coming from Psalm 138. Amen. Psalm 138, 1 verse 8. I will praise you with my whole heart. Before the gods, I will sing praises to you. I will worship toward your holy temple and praise your name for your loving kindness and your truth. For you have magnified your word, amen, above all your name. God has magnified his word. Amen. In all of our troubles, in all of our trials, praise God, let's turn back to the word of God. Let us know it is our sword. It is the sword of the Spirit. Amen. In the day when I cried to you, you answered me and made me bold with strength in my soul. All the kings of the earth shall praise you, O Lord, when they hear the words of your mouth. Yes, they shall sing of the ways of the Lord. For great is the glory of the Lord. Though the Lord is on high, yet he regards the lowly. But the proud he knows from afar. Though I walk in the midst of trouble, you will revive me. You will stretch out your hand against the wrath of my enemies, and your right hand will save me. The Lord will perfect that which concerneth me. Oh, my God, your mercy, O Lord, endures forever. Do not forsake the works of thine hands. I also want to end. This is all formatted to work together because I do have closing words. But I want to turn to the final word that goes along with the format that I'm going to summarize with. But I wanted God's word to precede anything that I have to say because God's word rules. Hallelujah. God's word, praise God, is victorious. God's word is the beginning and it is the end. Amen. Isaiah chapter 40, beginning with verse 28 to 31. If you'd like to go with me, then I invite you to do so. At verse 28, it says, have you not known? Have you not heard? The everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, neither faints nor is he weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the weak. And to those who have no might, he increases their strength. Even the youths shall faint and be weary. And the young men shall utterly fall. But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not faint. And they shall walk and not faint. They shall run, I say again, and not be weary. And they shall walk and not faint. So as I just want to thank God for his word. I wanted God's word to precede any summary. I'm a troubleshooter today by the power of the Holy Ghost. I am a troubleshooter today because I know that many of us have trouble in our home. We have trouble in our bodies. We have trouble in our minds. We have trouble in our family. There's trouble in the land. There's trouble in the White House. There's trouble all around the world. There's trouble in this life. But God sent his son. And God sent his word. Because his son was his word, that we might be redeemed from the curse of sin and death, that we might be redeemed from fear, from the anxiety of this COVID-19. We pray for those who have passed away and the families. We want to keep lifting up. We want to stay on our knees. It's praying time, my sisters and brothers. It's time for us to pray if you never prayed before. It's time for us to pray when it seems like we can barely get on our knees. It's time for us to pray if we can't do nothing but breathe a prayer. It's time for us to pray, even, praise God, when we don't feel like it. Amen. So I want to share 3 points like I always do. I end with 3 points. And I'm just going to summarize what the word of God has said. I'm troubleshooting today. I'm going to kill it dead with the word of God. The word of God, hallelujah, redeems us. The word of God comforts us. The word of God gives us courage. The word of God, praise God, gives us contentment. The word of God manifests, praise God, our desires and our hopes and our dreams. And I want to say 3 things, and I'm done. This is for somebody who's in trouble. Are you in trouble today? I want to say the first thing, get quiet, steal away, surrender all that's in your heart, pour it out before God in confession and repentant prayer. You know, the old song used to go, it may seem lonely right now, and it probably is because, you know, the old song goes, nobody wants you when you're down and out. But I have you to know today that God is there. And he tells us to draw nigh to him. And he'll draw nigh to us. Draw nigh to God in fasting, in prayer, and supplication. And 3, it may sound like more than 3, but it's my final point. Walk slowly with God, one step and one day at a time. Stay in his word. Listen for his comfort and his guidance, totally depending on him to deliver you moment by moment, day by day, one step at a time, and trust that he is the only help available, and that if he doesn't do it, it won't be done. And I also want to say this. If this trouble has come because of something you have done, ask God to forgive you sincerely and to help you learn the lesson from this trouble so that you will never find yourself in this trouble again. And if it's good trouble, ask God to give you the strength to endure. If it's good trouble, ask God to manifest himself so that many will be helped, many will be delivered, many will be set free. And as I end, I want to say, ask God to help you grow and learn. And final point, wait. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Because, the last scripture that I shared was talking about coming from Isaiah 40. That's the part, that's the hard part sometimes. If we can get through all the rest, that seemed like to be the biggest challenge for us. Amen. But I have you to know, amen, that God wants us to wait on him. God wants us to trust and know that he is God. And that he's God alone, and that we don't need our help. So we have to wait on him to do whatever it is that we need him to do. Praise the Lord. So I just wanted to leave that good enough. And I want you to praise God. Just think on those things. Think on those things and know that God is for you. And that if you know that God's word said that he is for you, then he is much, much more than those that are against you. Amen. So the next song that I want to share with you is entitled, I'm so glad, amen, that trouble don't last always. This is by Anthony Brown. Amen. You know, I just love him with his B.O.B. bounce. You're going to be hearing that on one of these shows. May God bless you through the holiday season. And may God go with you. And I want you to remember, and I want you to think on these things, praise God. I want you to think on what God is saying. It's not what Lovely's saying, but it's what God is saying. And I come and I bring you love. I bring you love in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Trouble don't last always. So I'm going to end it up with that. Remember that. Hallelujah. People of God, that I know that I'm so glad. I'm so glad that trouble don't last always. Hallelujah. And I want you to remember that too. Whatever trouble you're in, remember that you don't get to just pray and God never come. He's on his way. Help is on the way. He wouldn't be God if he didn't answer prayer. I want you to know that help is on his way. Hallelujah to God. he's on his way. If you can just hold on, hallelujah, to his word. You can just ask him to just quiet you. Sometimes I have to say, Lord, just quiet me. Hallelujah. But then all of a sudden I break out with a praise. Praise God. Sometimes we have to break out with what they call it, a crazy praise. Hey, glory. Trouble don't last always. Just remember that song. Sometimes a little song will come to you, and it'll comfort you in the course of a day. And it'll lift up your spirits. That's why I leave a message through a song. And I used to hear my mother singing around the house and my grandmother singing around the house, and it would touch me. And I know I didn't know God, honey. I tell you, I know I didn't know it, but you know what? It still blessed me. And it'll bless your children too. Amen. Even though they may not even be doing right, may not be acting right, but I tell you, the Spirit of God, hallelujah, will touch them through your song. You guys, be careful. You be safe. Praise God. Remember, you know what you gotta do. Amen. You know what you gotta do. Amen. You know what you gotta do to stay safe, to keep yourself, to keep your family safe, to keep others safe. Praise the Lord. But let us not be terrified. But let us, praise God, walk in faith. But wisdom. Amen. So I just want to say goodbye. Praise God. Like I always do at the end here. I've been trying to go, but sometimes it seems like the Spirit won't let me go. But I just want to ask you all to be a blessing to your children. Help them through this time. They're struggling. You know, this is a battle. We're going through spiritual warfare right now. This is spiritual warfare. And them same demons, which we don't realize, is dealing with us, they're dealing with them too. Amen. Oh, yes. Sometimes we just don't have, you know, the understanding sometimes that we think it just be us. But the enemy is after our children too. Amen. And we need to remember that the same demons that we have to rebuke from us, we have to rebuke from them in Jesus' name. Trouble. It's so encouraging to know that it don't last always. That's what keeps us going. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. I hope you all have, be careful driving up and down the dangerous streets. And I pray that you all will be careful. Amen. And God be with you in Jesus' name. I love you all.